How do we test voltage and why do we need to? Voltage is a relationship between two things. When we are sensing voltage, we're testing. You can kind of think of it as electrical pressure, sort of. It's a good analogy. It's not 100% accurate, but it's a kind of a pressure that exists, almost like when you take a Slinky and you pull it apart. Imagine being able to test the force at those two points. So when you let them go, whoom, the force comes together. In an electrical circuit, current flows because there is pressure. There's a potential. We call it a difference of potential. It just means voltage. But it's required that you know thing A and thing B and what they are, because sometimes in a circuit or in an environment, there are multiple different things that you could have voltage between, and you need to know how much voltage you have between everything. In a three-phase environment, you might have something that's a center-tapped delta where you've got 240 between all three of your different phases. You know, A and B's got 240. B and C's got 240 and C and A have 240. But if you test between neutral or ground to B phase, it might show 208. You need to know that so that you don't start putting breakers and loads, single phase loads, on a 208 circuit. Because if you think it's 120 and you go to put your vacuum cleaner, you know, plugged in, you're gonna fry that thing. So you need to know voltage between two things, what this is relative to this, 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 and this. So that's why it's really important to be able to test for voltage. Now, there are also things that should never have voltage between them, and that's really important too. So we use a multimeter that tests voltage between two things that should not have voltage. And if you ever get a service call or something because somebody is getting shocked every time they touch this metal door frame, you gotta start being able to test and know, okay, well, that's a metal thing that probably has something to do with grounding, maybe a neutral. So you're always gonna be testing multiple different places to see where is the pressure getting to this? What is the potential? What is at a different potential that's allowing current to flow through it? All right, to start out, let's talk about a couple of tool options. A lot of people use this thing. This is a tick tracer. It's a non-contact voltage tester, NCV. So that means that you don't have to make contact. You can just sense when there's voltage and the thing will light up. This is not telling me anything about anything. This is not telling me voltage. It says that it's a non-contact voltage tester. Well, what's the voltage? Is it 120? Is it 240? Like, how do we know? So using this thing is not actually accurate. And look, it's like reading way the hell out here because it uses capacitance. It doesn't use actual voltage. It's not telling you that there's a difference of potential between this thing and this thing. So it can give you a reading between the two things. Voltage is always a function of two different points, and it's the potential between those points. So this thing just sitting here squealing at you, every time I touch myself, I don't have voltage, but there is capacitive coupling that's happening between me and another thing. So it's just really inaccurate. And I tell people not to use these because unless you know what capacitive coupling is and you know actually how this thing works and what you're testing, it's gonna give you false positives a lot of the time. Most people will come up here, electricians, and they'll go like this. They'll be like, oh, breaker's on, go turn the breaker off. And that's what they're looking for this thing to stop making noise. And it usually works. It tells you if there's a presence of power, but it is not a voltage tester. It is not actually telling you any voltage, and it has voltage written all over it. Every brand's the same way. It's not voltage that it is telling you. So don't use this thing as a voltage tester. Just understand it's used for the presence of power to tell you if things are on or off. But I always, 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 because this thing is just not as reliable and it's not actually giving me any information, I always come over here and I grab a multimeter. And I want to use a multimeter to double check everything before just trusting this little tick tracer. Now, another thing I want to talk about is using one of these. So this is a plug tester. This does not tell you voltage either. This will tell me that the receptacle's hot, sure. It tells me that it's wired correctly, that, you know, everything's wired as it should. It'll also tell me if things are swapped backwards, but without using this, how do I know if the white has got voltage on it or not, right? So you can't use this for voltage either. This is just a plug tester. It's just letting you know the presence of power is there. It's kind of an on or off thing, and it'll also help you to let you know if you wired it forwards and backwards. So I actually use these quite a bit, but not to tell me voltage. And I need to know voltage. As an electrician, voltage matters more to me. One thing that recently came out is these little buggers. So Klein developed a plug tester. It's the same thing as the last one. It just actually gives you voltage values, which is really cool. Look at that, it tells me 125 volts that it's wired correctly. It'll let me know if there's a problem, if things are wired incorrectly. You can test just like if it's a GFCI, if you've got a GFCI somewhere, you can hit test and it'll trip it like the other one had. I just didn't talk about it, but it's good. It gives you some kind of information. And as an electrician, we need to know voltage. We need to know that information. So let's talk about how you actually test for voltage though, because not everything's a receptacle. You know, the only downside of this thing is that it's, you know, it only works on receptacles. But if we're testing in a panel or we're testing a receptacle and we actually want to know what's the voltage between this thing and this other thing, right? So we know here between hot or black and between white, we should have 120 volts. And we do, 125, I'm in a commercial setting, so my voltage is a little bit higher to this building. But also, we have 120 volts between ground and hot too, so I left my hot there. Now between ground, I should have 125 and I do, so that, cool, now I know everything, what it is relative to everything else. When we're testing voltage, we're trying to say, essentially, what's the pressure between these two things? If we go between neutral and ground, it should show 0 volts. There shouldn't be any pressure that can allow current to flow between the neutral and the ground because they're bonded together out at the surface. We don't want there to be a difference of potential. And that's all voltage is difference of potential. So it's telling us between two things. So let's look up here. I have this wired in a crazy, like, crazy way just for like demonstration purposes right now. There's no incoming conductors here because they're being fed through an extension cord into these breakers. The breakers are then feeding power to all of these little teeth, which makes the whole entire thing energized. So it allows me to get power up here as well. So I have this wired and it's not 220. I only have an extension cord that's got a black and a white and a green. So right here, you would think, oh, between each one of these, I should have 220 or 240, and I don't. So this is giving me information. Say out in the field, we lost a phase or something like that, and you're not getting 240 between A phase and B phase. Or, you know, maybe this is a little bit easier for you to see. There's no voltage between here. Well, damn, okay, what about the neutral? Oh, holy crap, there's 125 volts between hot and neutral. What about the other hot and neutral? There's still 125 volts. That's really weird. We didn't have anything here though. Well, it's because both of these are being fed, right? Our hot is coming in, it's plugged into a wall, it's jumped over here. So both of these hots are hot. They're just at the same potential because they're both touching each other. So this hot to neutral is reading 125. And this other phase, which is our B phase up here, is also reading 125. So both of them have 125 volts of potential between ground and hot, but they don't have any potential between the two of them because they're both at the same potential. It's literally, they're touching each other. It's the same exact thing. So then we could go, okay, well, what about, you know, neutral to ground, or what about hot to ground? We should get the same thing, right? 125 volts between a hot and a ground. And we should get nothing between our ground and our neutral, and it shows 0 volts. Because again, grounds and neutrals all the way out at the surface are actually bonded together. There's a little, either a wire jumper that goes between them, or a lot of times there's a screw like this one has, and we'll put that screw right in this hole and we smash it through, and that takes all of our neutrals and it touches them to this metal can, and this metal can is touching this ground bus. So ground, panel, metal, and neutral are all touching each other because we use this bonding screw to bond it all. We only do that at the service. We don't ever do it in an inside panel like this, but it just goes to show you, since the all of the neutrals and the panel and the ground are at the same exact potential, they're all one giant piece of metal. So why would there be a difference of potential between them? There isn't, because they're the same piece of metal. That's why you're gonna get no voltage between ground and neutral. Now, if you're ever on a job and you do have voltage between ground and neutral, then you have a grounding problem or a neutral problem, and you need to go investigate that because somebody could actually get shocked and it's really dangerous. But that is voltage. So you can understand now why a tester gives you values. It gives you numbers because you're trying to see, well, does this have voltage between this? Is there voltage between this and this? Using this thing to sit here and just beep at you, look, It just beeps no matter what you touch. I don't even have to touch anything. I'm just near all of this. What is this telling you? It does it next to the neutral sometimes. It does it, well, it doesn't do it on the ground. But it's there's no useful information here. So only use this for the presence of power. Sorry, I should probably shut that off while I'm talking to you. Or use it because it's got a cool laser on it. And if you're a journeyman and you're telling people what to do, you can shoot it across the wall. And you can be like, hey, go run in between here, run a little box, or go like, oh, go make those wire nuts up right there. That's the reason I use this thing. But if you're testing voltage, use this thing. Go spend the $100, keep one in your garage, and use it every time you ever mess with electricity. But I'm gonna recommend, as an electrician, that you hire me instead and don't mess with electricity. So that is voltage. Thank you guys so much for watching. I love you crazy people, and I will see you in the next one.